We can have a great life, but we always build this reality around the one thing we don't have. So therefore, our great life, we don't even see it. We see the one piece of clothing we weren't able to get versus the amazing things we have. So we focus on that. I was the king of focusing on the one bad thing in my life. The one bad person called me nigger. Everything bad, I focused on that. But over here was a beautiful reality of my life. Even though I came from nothing, where I could have taken my mind for the possibilities of where I can go if I work harder. That was all over here, but I lived in the filth over here. So basically, what I started doing was, when I was 297, I thought about, my God, man, like this could be my life. And I thought, okay, what does heaven look like? I don't know. No one does, I imagine. So I was like, okay, I imagine that there's a big long line and you got judgment and you're God. Let's say you're God and I'm just David Goggins. Big long line and you're talking to Jane Doe. Jane Doe goes by and behind you is a big whiteboard. And the whiteboard has like just a piece of paper and you pull it down. The next person in line is David Goggins. And on this board, it has all this stuff on it, but I can't see because I'm too far back in line. So I come up, I sit down, now you're talking to me. David, congratulations, you made it to heaven. How you feel? And right now I'm 300-pound man. Ecolab guy, I'm 71 years old. This is what I'm thinking at 24 years old, okay? I'm dead, I'm in heaven, you're God. You pull the paper down, it says David Goggins. I'm reading it and I'm looking at it and it has my name, but on this paper it says everything about you. Everything, because God knows all. And I'm looking at it and I'm seeing 185 pounds, Navy SEAL, changed people's lives, all these amazing things. Public speaker, blah, 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 motivational, all the best-selling book. I look at God, I said, God, the name is right, but what's on here is not me. He goes, it should have been you. This was the life that you were supposed to live, but you didn't try. So this is the life that you have. So what I think to myself is, are you in heaven? Am I talking to God or am I talking to the devil? Because I'm in hell now to see that that was supposed to be my life, but because I didn't try hard enough, because I didn't put forth every single bit of an ounce of pressure in my body into being better. They ended up being a 300-pound guy that made $1,000 a month and I was fine there. That was okay. So that's how my mind works. It works that way to see, where is this gonna take me? What's the possibility?
Well, I have resets, but my resets are like, I call them aid stations, mental aid stations. Mm. So when you're going fucking hard and you grind all the fucking time, like everybody knows you're 24 hours in a day, but when I'm in the shower, it's a mental aid station. Mm-hmm. I don't think about shit. I don't fucking think about people. I don't think about work, I don't think about running, I don't think about working out. When I'm in the car, another fucking mental aid station. When I'm fucking eating, mental aid station. So people eat and they work and all this other shit, man. So I can grind hard because a lot of times, man, I'm in mental fucking aid stations.
Mm.
Chilling.
So you have little mini vacations.
Mini vacations, man, yeah. All day long.
We humans are not really truth-seeking animals. We are social animals. And, you know, take you back in time 10,000 years and you're in a small village. If you go along to get along, you can survive. You can procreate. If you're the village truth teller, you might get clubbed to death in the middle of the night. Truths are often, they don't want to be heard because important truths can be uncomfortable, they can be awkward, they can be exhausting, they can make people defensive, even if that's not the intent. But any high-performing organization, whether it's a sports team, a business, you know, a political organization, an activist group, I don't care what it is, any high-performing organization has to have mechanisms and a culture that supports truth-telling. One of the things you have to do is you have to talk about that. And you have to talk about the fact that it takes energy to do that. And you have to talk to people. You have to remind people it's okay that it's uncomfortable. You have to literally tell people it's not what we're designed to do as humans. It's not really, It's kind of a side effect. You know, we can do that, but it's not how we survive. We mostly survive by being social animals and being cordial and cooperative. And that's really important. And so there's a, you know, science is all about truth telling. It's actually a very formal mechanism for trying to tell the truth. And even in science, you find that it's hard to tell the truth. Mm-hmm. Right. Even, you know, you're supposed to have hypothesis and test it and find data and reject the hypothesis and so on. It's not easy. You want to set up your culture so that the most junior person can overrule the most senior person if they have data.
Your body is your unconscious mind. And it does not know the difference between an experience in your life that produces an emotion and an emotion that you fabricate by thought alone. To the body, it's the same. It believes it's in the experience over and over again. So if you begin to think unworthy thoughts, wouldn't you agree that you're going to begin to feel unworthy? And the moment you feel unworthy, aren't you going to think more unworthy thoughts? Then you're going to feel more unworthy. Then think more unworthy. And then finally, you're going to say, I am unworthy. And whenever you say I am anything, what you're saying is my mind and body are working together. My thoughts and feelings are aligned to a destiny. So if you understand then that feelings are the record of the past and those feelings are driving your thoughts, are you thinking in the future or are you thinking in the past? And as long as you're thinking in the past and you believe that your thoughts have something to do with your destiny, what are you creating more of? Now, that cycle of thinking and feeling creates a state of being, and a state of being is your personality. And that chemical continuity becomes so familiar to you that that becomes your identity after 35. And all of a sudden, when we want to change, and we're not going to think the same thoughts or behave the same way or live by the same emotions, and we disrupt this chemical continuity, it feels uncomfortable. Because now all of a sudden it's unfamiliar. And now you're stepping outside of the old self. And at least when you suffered, you could predict the next reason to suffer. Now all of a sudden you're not suffering. Now what are you going to do? So then if thoughts and feelings produce an imprint in the quantum field, that invisible field that exists beyond time and space that's responsive to how you think and feel, then if you're walking around in your life in a state of suffering and you're broadcasting an electromagnetic signature, what you're saying is, okay, field, bring me more reasons to suffer, but bring them in a way that I least expect, that surprise me, that leave no doubt that they've come from you.
I know that I am pure spirit. That I always have been, and that I always will be. There is inside me a place of confidence and quietness and security where all things are known and understood. This is the universal mind, God, of which I am a part, and which responds to me as I ask of it. This universal mind knows the answer to all of my problems, and even now, the answers are speeding their way to me. I needn't struggle for them. I needn't worry or strive for them. When the time comes, the answers will be there. I give my problems to the great mind of God. I let go of them, confident that the correct answers will return to me when they are needed. Through the great law of attraction, everything in life that I need for my work and fulfillment will come to me. It is not necessary that I strain about this, only believe, for in the strength of my belief, my faith will make it so. I see the hand of divine intelligence all about me, in the flower, the tree, the brook, the meadow. I know that the intelligence that created all these things is in me and around me, and that I can call upon it for my slightest need. I know that my body is a manifestation of pure spirit, and that spirit is perfect. Therefore, my body is perfect also. I enjoy life, for each day brings a constant demonstration of the power and wonder of the universe and myself. I am confident, I am serene, I am sure. No matter what obstacle or undesirable circumstance crosses my path, I refuse to accept it, for it is nothing but illusion. There can be no obstacle or undesirable circumstance to the mind of God, which is in me, around me, and serves me now.